most people in America are looking for how do I make a life worth living and retirement worth having. When illegal and immoral people want to hurt someone, they monitor their computers and their cell phones. I was in the process of buying a domain, but I think a little girl came back at night while I was sleeping and got onto my computer because each time I kept finding my battery of my computer gone. Here I've spent my whole morning working on computers, and openly we've got a maintenance man playing around with the electricity of a building. We also have people that are here who are Hispanic as a group, and one of them speaks incredibly good English. But here's my problem. What I see them doing is replacing a roof from brown to black. My question is it really necessary to do that? Or is the rent population of this space and this place able to afford that? I realize these are national companies on this block, but my curiosity is, you know, when somebody upgrades a roof, they usually amortize it over the clients so that the clients have to pay more money. But what I'm curious about is how many people in these companies now are Hispanic, and how did they come about to have all this ability to purchase property and to become property management companies? And where did they get their funding, and how did they get their licensing, and who reviewed them in terms of Homeland Security? So forgive me for being a little bit, well, ethnocentric for Americans in general, as a very diverse population with people who are legitimately here with birth certificates here. And I really hate this concept of the dreamers, because what I think it feels like is that people who are of indigency just get a free ride in America, where people like me who had to pay through the nose to help really important people in my life as an American citizen come over to America, that it's not fair to them. And I don't like that. I think it's unfair. But what I'm more concerned about are the people who run these shops. Why aren't they doing this work from the back of the house? Why do we have to have our federally protected handicap up-ramps and sidewalks blocked off for the day in order for them to do their work? Why can't they do the roofing from the back of the building? There's plenty of space back there for them to park their cars, park their trucks, and to get themselves up there. What is the deal with that? Is it because they have to have someone on the front to be able to see whether things are aligned or not? And my question is, how do these people get their licensing to do their work? How do we know that they're actually doing the work correctly for us? Now, the thing that makes me absolutely amazed that here I'm sitting here in the middle of practically buttfuck nowhere, and one of my girl's signs comes riding in front of me. Isn't that amazing how God teaches you things? How God says, this one's important to you, don't ever forget it.